Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with a Valentine's Day card. Today I will be using this exclusive stamp set by Simon Says Stamp, and it is called Roses For You, and it also comes with a matching die set that cuts all those little bits and pieces, from the little flowers to the little leaves and everything. So first of all, I am going to be using my Versamark ink, and I will be stamping a couple of times the three little roses. So I am just using some white cardstock to stamp all those little roses, and then I will go ahead and stamp the leaves. Now you probably can't see anything at the moment just because I'm using my Versamark ink, but you will see how all the images will be revealed once I apply my color. Once I have stamped all the images, I am going to apply my embossing powder, and today I'm using Bright White Embossing Powder by WOW. For coloring my images today, I decided to use my Distress ink pads. So for all the roses, I am using Spun Sugar, and for all the leaves, I will be using Shabby Shatters. Now I am applying the ink with a finger dabber, and I'm not doing any type of shading. I just want my card today to be simple and elegant, and I am going for all those pale colors. Once I have all the images colored, I will be using all those different dyes, and I am going to pass it through my die cutting machine. When you are using dyes for die cutting your images, you get that white border around them, but I don't have it today for all those die cuts, just because I used my finger dabbers and I added color around the images, so I have nice solid colored images today for my card. Of course, you can use your markers and color only inside the lines, so it actually depends on the look you are going for. In the same die set, there is this heart, which I am running it through my Sizzix machine at the moment, and you will see that I will be using this heart twice today for both the negative and the positive die cut. In the stamp set, there is a stamp that matches perfectly this heart outline, and again I am going to do the same technique. I am going to stamp it with Versamark ink, apply my white embossing powder, and then color it with Spun Sugar. I have a piece of this beautiful wood grain textured cardstock, and I'm going to die cut the heart. So now I have the negative one. And although I have passed it through my Sizzix machine, I didn't lose that texture on the paper. And that's a paper by Simon Says Stamp. So to cover up that hole, I am going to use some vellum at the back, and I am securing it with my tape runner. I always like to add a touch of vellum when I am going for soft and romantic cards, because I think that it adds that touch of elegance on my cards. I am just cutting out the excess, and now I have a nice window. For today I am not going for a shaker card, but I think that this window with the vellum really makes the card. I am going to stick the outline heart inside that window, and for that I used my matte medium. That's just matte medium on a fine tip applicator. I am placing it down and it fits perfectly. So now I can arrange my flowers. Now for the flowers I will be using some foam tape at the back, and this is going to add a little bit of dimension on my card, but I'm not pressing them down too hard because I am planning to rearrange them depending on where I will be sticking the sentiment. For the sentiment, I am going with a phrase that was in the stamp set that says, "You have my heart." And again, I'm using the same technique, stamping it with Versamark, applying my white embossing powder, heat setting it with my heat gun, and then apply some spun sugar. I have used foam squares at the back of the sentiment banner to stick it on my card, and now I will rearrange the flowers just to make a nice cluster around the heart and the banner. And for such a sweet card, I just couldn't stay away from my clear Wink of Stella glitter pen, so I'm just adding a little bit of shimmer on the roses as well as on the heart outline. To finish off my card, I will be adding a few pearls on the center of the flowers as well as scatter them along my card. I have added foam tape at the back and I'm going to stick it on a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. The card base is made out of the same wood grain textured cardstock, and it's a beautiful card that you can not only use for Valentine's Day but also for anniversaries and weddings. And that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. Here are some close-up photos of the card. If you liked the project, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as click the like button and also share it with your friends. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more Valentine's Day cards that I made a while back. Thank you all for watching!